is going to be a listening comprehension exercise for you. Listen intently as you will be asked to write a summary of the story at the end. Let's listen to the story. The Three Questions by Tolstoy, from the collection What Men Live By and Other Tales, translated by L. and A. Maud. It once occurred to a certain king that if he always knew the right time to begin everything, if he knew who were the right people to listen to and whom to avoid, and above all, if he always knew what was the most important thing to do, he would never fail. Then again, others said there were some things which could not wait to be laid before a council, but about which one had at once to decide whether to undertake them or not. But in order to decide that, one must know beforehand what was going to happen. It is only magicians who know that, and therefore, in order to know the right time for every action, one must consult magicians. Equally various were the answers to the second question. Some said the people the king most needed were his counselors, others the priests, others the doctors, while some said the warriors were the most necessary. Thank you. that the most important thing in the world was science. Others said it was skill in warfare, and others again that it was religious worship. All the answers being different, the king agreed with none of them and gave the reward to none. But still wishing to find the right answers to his questions, he decided to consult a hermit, widely renowned for his wisdom. The hermit lived in a home which he never quitted, and he received none but common folk. So the king put on simple clothes and, before reaching the hermit's cell, dismounted from his horse and, leaving his bodyguard behind, went on alone. Listened to the king, but answered nothing. He just spat on his hand and recommenced digging. "You are tired," said the king. "Let me take the spade and work a while for you." "Thanks," said the hermit, and giving the spade to the king, he sat down on the ground. When he had done two bends, the king stopped and repeated his questions. The hermit again gave no answer, but rose, stretched out his hand for the spade and said, "Now rest a while and let me work a bit." But the king did not give him the spade and continued to dig. 1 hour passed and another. The sun began to sink behind the trees, and the king at last stuck the spade into the ground and said, "I came to you, wise man, for answers to my questions. If you can give me none, tell me so, and I'll return home." "Here for something to drink. The king brought fresh water and gave it to him. Taking leave of the wounded man, the king went out into the porch and looked around for the hermit. Before going away, he wished once more to beg an answer to the questions he had put. The hermit was outside, on his knees, sowing seeds in the beds that had been dug the day before. The king approached him and said, "For the last time, I pray you to answer my questions, wise man. You have already been answered," said the hermit, still crouching on his thin legs and looking up at the king, who stood before him. "How answered?" What do you mean? Asked the king. Not see, replied the hermit. If you had not pitied my weakness yesterday and had not dug those beds for me, but had gone your way, that man would have attacked you, and you would have repented of not having stayed with me. So the most important time was when you were digging the beds, and I was the most important man. And to do me good was your most important business. Afterwards, when that man ran to us, the most important time was when you were attending to him. For if you had not bound up his wounds, he would have died without having made peace with you. So he was the most important man, and what you did for him was your most important business. Of the story The Three Questions by Leo Tolstoy. I hope you have listened intently. Now, please write a summary of the story within 200 words.